game of if you can start pa.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين سيدنا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. My dear respected brothers and sisters, welcome to our weekly class at Osaka Ibaraki Masjid. This class, as usual, we study one page of the Holy Quran, and then we start to know some of its meanings, and at the end we study the tajweed related to the ayat. Inshallah, today we'll study the ayat Surah Az-Zumar from ayah 22 until ayah 31. Again, we'll study the ayat inshallah from ayah 22 Surah Az-Zumar. Surah Az-Zumar, the surah 39, the number of the surah 39. The page number 461. So please prepare yourself, prepare the Quran, the Mus'haf you have. So inshallah, before starting, let's remind one another about refreshing our niyyah, our intention to be for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and be sure you will be rewarded by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala whenever or wherever you are, if you are in the masjid with us or you are following us online. Just purify your niyyah that you are spending this time for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for the purpose of studying ayat of the Holy Quran and to know the meaning of those ayat, and then to know also the tajweed which related to the ayat. After we finish also we have question and answers. So inshallah, if any brother or sister having any question, he can inshallah feel free to ask inshallah. Now inshallah we'll start. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
أفمن شرح الله صدره للإسلام.
أفمن شرح الله صدره للإسلام.
أفمن شرح شرح الله صدره للإسلام.
أفمن شرح الله صدره للإسلام.
فهو على نور من ربه.
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 فويل للقاسية قلوبهم من ذكر الله.
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 أولئك في ضلال مبين
أولئك في ضلال مبين
أولئك في ضلال مبين
أولئك في ضلال
الله نزل أحسن الحديث كتابا
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 كتابا متشابها مثاني
كتابا متشابها مثاني
كتابا متشابها مثاني
كتابا متشابها مثاني
تقشعر منه جلود الذين يخشون ربهم تقشعر منه جلود الذين يخشون ربهم
تقشعر منه جلود الذين يخشون ربهم
تقشعر منه جلود الذين يخشون ربهم
تقشعر منه جلود الذين يخشون ربهم
تقشعر منه جلود الذين يخشون ربهم
تقشعر منه جلود الذين يخشون ربهم
ثم تلين جلودهم وقلوبهم إلى ذكر الله
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 ذلك هدى الله يهدي به من يشاء
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 ومن يضلل الله فما له من هاد
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 أفمن يتقي بوجهه سوء العذاب يوم القيامة
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 وقيل للظالمين ذوقوا ما كنتم تكسبون
وقيل للظالمين ذوقوا ما كنتم تكسبون
وقيل للظالمين ذوقوا ما كنتم تكسبون
وقيل للظالمين نذوقوا ما كنتم تكسبون
كذب الذين من قبلهم
كذب الذين من قبلهم
كذب الذين من قبلهم
كذب الذين من قبلهم
فأتاهم العذاب من حيث لا يشعرون
فأتاكم العذاب من حيث لا يشعرون
فأتاهم العذاب من حيث لا يشعرون
فأتاكم العذاب من حيث لا يشعرون
فأذاقهم الله الخزي في الحياة الدنيا
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 ولعذاب الآخرة أكبر
ولعذاب الآخرة أكبر
ولعذاب الآخرة أكبر
ولعذاب الآخرة أكبر
لو كانوا يعلمون
لو كانوا يعلمون
لو كانوا يعلمون
لو كانوا يعلمون
ولقد ضربنا للناس في هذا القرآن
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 من كل مثل
من كل مثل
من كل مثل
من كل مثل
من كل مثل لعلهم يتذكرون
من كل مثل لعلهم يتذكرون
من كل مثل لعلهم يتذكرون قرآنا عربيا غير ذي عوج
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 غير ذي عوج لعلهم يتقون
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 ضرب الله مثلا رجلا فيه شركاء
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 شركاء متشاكسون
شركاء متشاكسون
شركاء متشاكسون
شركاء متشاكسون
ضرب الله مثلا رجلا فيه شركاء متشاكسون
ضرب الله مثلا رجلا فيه شركاء متشاكسون
ورجلا سلما لرجل
ورجلا سلما لرجل
ورجلا سلما لرجل
ورجلا سلما لرجل
هل يستويان مثلا
هل يستويان مثلا
هل يستويان مثلا
هل يستويان مثلا
الحمد لله
الحمد لله
بل أكثرهم لا يعلمون
بل أكثرهم لا يعلمون
الحمد لله بل أكثرهم لا يعلمون
الحمد لله بل أكثرهم لا يعلمون
إنك ميت وإنهم ميتون
إنك ميت وإنهم ميتون
إنك ميت وإنهم ميتون
إنك ميت وإنهم ميتون
ثم إنكم يوم القيامة
ثم إنكم يوم القيامة
ثم إنكم يوم القيامة
ثم إنكم يوم القيامة
عند ربكم تختصمون
عند ربكم تختصمون
عند ربكم تختصمون
عند ربكم تختصمون
So alhamdulillah after we recited the ayah together I will recite myself inshallah please follow me
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم أفمن شرح الله صدره للإسلام فهو على نور من ربه فويل للقاسية قلوبهم من ذكر الله أولئك في ضلال مبين الله نزل أحسن الحديث كتابا متشابها مثاني تقشعر منه جلود الذين يخشون تقشعر منه جلود الذين يخشون ربهم ثم تلين جلودهم وقلوبهم إلى ذكر الله ذلك هدى الله يهدي به من يشاء ومن يضلل الله فما له من هاد أفمن يتقي بوجهه سوء العذاب يوم القيامة وقيل للظالمين ذوقوا ما كنتم تكسبون كذب الذين من قبلهم فأتاهم العذاب من حيث لا يشعرون فأذاقهم الله الخزي في الحياة الدنيا ولعذاب الآخرة أكبر لو كانوا يعلمون ولقد ضربنا للناس في هذا القرآن من كل مثل لعلهم يتذكرون قرآنا عربيا غير ذي عوج لعلهم يتقون ضرب الله مثلا رجلا فيه شركاء متشاكسون ورجلا سلما لرجل هل يستويان مثلا الحمد لله بل أكثرهم لا يعلمون إنك ميت وإنهم ميتون ثم إنكم يوم القيامة عند ربكم تختصمون
الحمد لله رب العالمين إن شاء الله I hope everyone now can recite the آيات إن شاء الله properly. Now let's go to the meaning of the ayat. The first ayah, أَفَمَنْ شَرَحَ اللَّهُ صَدَرَهُ لِلْإِسْلَامِ فَهُوَ عَلَى نُورٍ مِّنْ رَبِّهِ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this ayah talking about the people, their hearts opened by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept the guidance of Islam. The guidance only in the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Holy Quran to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِنَّكَ لَا تَهْدِي مَنْ أَحْبَبْتِ وَلَكِنَّ اللَّهَ يَهْدِي مَنْ يَشَاءُ The meaning, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you cannot guide the people you like. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the only one who guides the people he likes. So the guidance to the right path only coming from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why here in the ayah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said شَرَحَ اللَّهُ صَدَرَهُ لِلْإِسْلَامِ Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open his heart to accept the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through Islam. فَهُوَ عَلَى نُورٍ مِّنْ رَبِّهِ This person who guided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he having nur, he having light. This light guiding him always to the right path, always to the right things. This nur, this light from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in his heart, showing him the right is right and the wrong is wrong. Because unfortunately, sometimes some people, they cannot see things clearly. They see right is wrong and the wrong is right. But for the people who are guided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala show them right is right, wrong is wrong. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving them something we called Furqan. Furqan. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Holy Quran, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِن تَتَّقُوا اللَّهَ يَجْعَلْ لَكُمْ فُرْقَانًا If you have taqwa, fear of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you furqan. Furqan means light from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to see things in the proper way. To see right is right and to see wrong is wrong. Not to have any confusion. فَوَيْلٌ لِلْقَاسِيَةِ قُلُوبُهُمْ مِنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ After Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about those people who are guided by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about the opposite people. Their hearts are hard. قَاسِيَةِ قُلُوبُهُمْ مِنْ ذِكْرِ اللَّهِ Means their hearts are very hard, not easy to be open
to the guidance or to receive the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Those people, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warning them. Also, this leads us to one question very important. And I got it from some brothers and sisters before. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when giving guidance to someone, of course Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala knows that this person or this heart searching or seeking for guidance. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guided him. But for the hearts or the heart which is not seeking guidance, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will leave it. أُولَٰئِكَ فِي ضَلَالٍ مُّبِينٍ. Those people who having the hard hearts, they are in the very big misguidance. الله نزل أحسن الحديث. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala نزل means revealed. نزل, revealed. أحسن الحديث. أحسن الحديث. أحسن means the best. أحسن means the best. الحديث speech. So best of speech. What is the meaning? القرآن. القرآن الكريم. This is the best of speech. الله نزل أحسن الحديث means القرآن الكريم. كتابا. كتاب book. Same as سورة البقرة. ذلك الكتاب لا ريب فيه. So الكتاب means the Holy Quran. متشابها مثانية تقشعر منه جلود الذين يخشون ربهم. متشابها here doesn't mean the same meaning of the ayat at the beginning of Surah Al Imran. The ayat in Surah Al Imran. The beginning of the ayat, we can go also to check by ourselves. Surah Al Imran. The ayah number 7. If you have the Mus'haf, now you can, inshallah, so open Surah آل عمران آية 7. All brothers okay? You can see? Okay. The آية هو الذي أنزل عليك الكتاب منه آيات محكمات هن أم الكتاب وأخر متشابهات وأخر متشابهات. Then the remainder of the ayah. فأما الذين في قلوبهم زيغ فيتبعون ما تشابه منه ابتغاء الفتنة وابتغاء تأويله وما يعلم تأويله إلا الله والراسخون في العلم يقولون آمنا به كل من عند ربنا وما يذكر إلا أولو الألباب. Okay, what I want to say in this ayah number 7 in Surah Al Imran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said أخر متشابهات. متشابهات. Okay, the word here متشابهات. Okay, in Surah Al-Zumar Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also said كتابا متشابها. So, Surah Al-Imran, متشابهات. In Surah Al-Zumar, متشابها. Is the meaning is same? No. The meaning here is not same. The meaning in Surah Al-Imran is different of the meaning in Surah Al-Zumar. Okay? The meaning in Surah Az-Zumar, كِتَابًا مُتَشَابِهًا مَثَانِيًا, means all the ayat of Al-Quran Al-Kareem are similar of giving guidance to the people. This is the meaning here for this ayah 23 in Surah Az-Zumar. But of course, in Surah Al-Imran, the meaning is different. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in the ayah, in Surah Al-Imran, ayah number 7, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made comparison between ayat muhkamat and ayat mutashabihat. So there are two types of ayat. Ayat muhkamat and ayat mutashabihat. Ayat muhkamat means the ayat which having a very clear meaning, which doesn't need too much efforts from a person to get the proper meaning. But the ayat mutashabihat means the ayat which sometimes difficult for some people to understand the proper meaning of the ayat. So they need to get knowledge and to get guidance from the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad SAW to understand it. But here in Surah Az-Zumar, mutashabihan here means the ayat of Al-Quran are similar for giving guidance to people. تقشعر منه جلود الذين يخشون ربهم. When the people who are fearing Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when they listen to the ayat of Al-Quran al-Kareem, they getting khushu'a, they getting in their hearts a very good and very highly emotion and feeling. When the ayat talking about paradise, Jannah, the hearts of the believers are hoping that they will be from the people of Jannah. When the ayat talking about punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the believers, they are scaring and hoping that they will not be among those who are punished by the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Jahannam. ذلك هدى الله يهدي به من يشاء. This is guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also, as we said at the beginning, guidance from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to the hearts of the people according to their intention of receiving hidayah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. أَفَمَنْ يَتَّقِي بِوَجْهِهِ سُوءَ الْعَذَابِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. In this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asking this actually in a question form. أَفَمَنْ يَتَّقِي بِوَجْهِهِ سُوءَ الْعَذَابِ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ. For a person, أو العياذ بالله, who will be from the people of Jahannam. So those people will facing Jahannam by their faces. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is asking those people who are punished by Jahannam and they are facing Jahannam, and they thinking at the same time they are protecting the other parts of their bodies by facing the fire of Jahannam by their faces. Here, okay, the question of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is those people who are facing the fire of Jahannam by their faces, and then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and for the oppressors, Allah will say to them, to test the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for their sins. Now, actually, my dear brothers, the question is not complete, or we can say the comparison is not complete. Please try to get my point. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asking, is those who are facing the fire of Jahannam, okay, and it will say to the oppressors to test the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now this question is not complete. Okay? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't complete this question. Why? Why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't complete the ayah by giving the other or the opposite example? Because it's well known for minds. One of the great miracles of Al-Quran al-Kareem, that Al-Quran al-Kareem in the best level of Arabic language. And in the Arabic language, you can say something and not saying another things because it's already known by the people who are listening to you. This is here same in this ayah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't say those people who are facing the fire of Jahannam is better, or those who are enjoying in paradise. But the last part is not mentioned. Why? Because it's already known. When you are listening to this first part, at the time it comes to your mind the comparison between those people who are punished in Jahannam and the other people who are enjoying in Jannah. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala didn't say the second. Because anyone listening, he will get by himself naturally this image. كذب الذين من قبلهم. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking about the previous nations who denied the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala given to them through their prophets and messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So they are the people of Mecca or the people of Quraysh. They are not the first people doing this same denying. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to say to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, don't feel sad because the people who are denying your guidance, because they are not the first people doing that. Before them, other previous nations, they did the same. If we go to Nuh alayhi salam, go to Ibrahim alayhi, all the prophets, you will find that not all people listen to their guidance or receiving their guidance. Many of the people, they didn't believe, they denied, and the result that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punished, فَأَتَاهُمُ الْعَذَابُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punished them. We saw in Al-Quran al-Kareem how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punished the people of Nuh, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punished the people of Salih, how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala punished the people of Lut alayhi salam, how Allah punished the people of Hud. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned to us the strong punishment given to those who denied the guidance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. فَأَذَاقَهُمُ اللَّهُ الْخِزْيَ فِي الْحَيَاةِ الدُّنْيَا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving them punishment in this life, and in the hereafter the punishment will be more stronger. وَلَقَدْ ضَرَبْنَا لِلنَّاسِ فِي هَذَا الْقُرْآنِ مِنْ كُلِّ مَثَلٍ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving people examples in the Holy Quran to give them the clear image about what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to say to them. And subhanAllah, the previous ayat which we talked, all comparisons from the first ayah we recited 22 until now, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving this comparison between believers and non-believers, between the punishment and the enjoyment and the others. قرآنا عربيا غير ذي عوج. The Quran in the Arabic language. And this is actually Al-Quran Al-Kareem. He was revealed to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in people of Quraysh, the Arab people. And at that time, the Arab people, they were in the very high level in the language. Not like now. So the Quran was miracle. It challenging the people that this Quran by your language. But can you create a similar book like this? They couldn't. Then Allah said, okay, can you create 10 surah? They couldn't. Then Allah said to them, can you create even one surah? They couldn't. SubhanAllah, even they are in the very highest level of language, but they couldn't create any ayat or any surah similar to the surahs of the Quran. قرآنا عربيا غير ذي عوج. You cannot find any mistake in the Quran. Of course, some people who are not believing in Islam and they tried their best to find any mistake, but they couldn't. They couldn't find any mistake in the Holy Quran. Why? Because we believe that this is not our, not in our level. This is the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's why it's completely perfect. ضرب الله مثلا رجلا فيه شركاء متشاكسون ورجلا سلما لرجل هل يستويان مثلا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving another comparison about a slave and this one slave, but the owners are many. It means one slave for many people, many owners for one slave. And the problem that those owners are mutashakisun. Mutashakisun means they are not good with one another. They have different minds. So can you imagine if there is one slave or one servant, and this servant receiving many different orders from his owners? Someone say go to right, the one get left one. How this person will feeling? How is feeling? Will be in very, very bad, very sad. The other example, one slave for one man. Which slave is better? The first one or the second one? The second one, of course. Because he has only one owner. This is, my dear brothers and sisters, this is also for a person. If he is only slave of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or slave to many other things, which is better? To be slave of Allah only. This is the best. The best, to have only one honor, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At that time you will feel comfortable and relaxed. إِنَّكَ مَيِّتٌ وَإِنَّهُمْ مَيِّتُونَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talking to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you will die. And also they will die. You will die and these believers also will die. Nobody will live forever. ثم إنكم يوم القيامة عند ربكم تختصمون. Then the judgment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be in yawm al-qiyamah. Allah will judge everyone according to his belief, according to his deeds done in his lifetime. Okay, now before inshallah receiving your questions, let's talk about the tajweed. Brothers also are following us in online. Please go to the ayat, the first ayah. أَفَمَنْ شَرَحَ اللَّهُ. The ayah 22nd. We have noon. أَفَمَنْ, this the noon ساكنة, noon سكون. Maybe when you look to the Mus'haf, the Quran, you will find the noon have nothing. Noon have nothing. There is no fatha, no kasra, no dhamma, no sukoon. So usually when we have noon like this, it means this noon having sukoon. So when you see any noon in Al-Quran, have no haraka, no fatha, no kasra, no dhamma like this, you know this is noon sukoon. So now we have noon sukoon and then sheen. Sheen. Okay, noon sheen. In this case, we make something called ikhfa haqiqi. Ikhfa haqiqi. إخفاء حقيقي. What is the meaning of إخفاء حقيقي? إخفاء حقيقي means you will not pronounce the noon clearly. In the ordinary reading, we will say أفمن شرح. أفمن شرح. But for the Quran, if I say أَفَمَنْ شَرَحَ, wrong. I did mistake in تجويد. So I have to not pronounce the noon clearly. I will hide the noon in sheen. So I will not say أَفَمَنْ شَرَحَ, but I will say أَفَمَنْ شَرَحَ. Look, if you noted, I didn't say the noon clearly. I hided the noon in sheen. Again, أَفَمَنْ شَرَحَ, أَفَمَنْ شَرَحَ. This we called إخفاء حقيقي. And inshallah in the future, inshallah we can also show to brothers and sisters the explanation written in on screen inshallah. شَرَحَ اللَّهُ. شرح. Then after شرح, we have the لفظ الجلالة, the word Allah. Here, as we explained before many times, when the word Allah, لفظ الجلالة, before it there is فتحة, like in this ayah, we have to pronounce the word Allah with tafkhim to make it strong. Like we say sharahallahu, sharahallahu. Look, we pronounce the word Allah very strong. But when we have before the word Allah kasra, at the time we make opposite, we make something we called tarqiq. Tarqiq means you will pronounce the word Allah in soft way. Like for example, when you say Bismillah, you say Bismillah, you don't say Bism Allah. You make tarqiq. Why? Because in the before the word Allah there is kasra. You say Bismi, Bismi, kasra, and then you say Bismillah. But if before the word Allah there is dhamma or fatha, at the time we have to make it tafkhim, strong. Bismillah, like this one, شرح الله, or يقول الله, also ضمة, we have to make it tafkhim. صاد راه دال قلقلة, دال having سكون, so we make قلقلة. صدره للإسلام فهو على نور من, نور من. So here نور, نور we have تنوين, تنوين بالكسرة, تو كسرة, نور. And then after that ميم. So the ruling here is إدغام بغنة, إدغام with غنة. إدغام means to change the تنوين into ميم. So in ordinary we will say نور من, نور من. But when we are reciting according to تجويد, we will not say like this. We will say نور من, نور من. We don't say نور. We change the تنوين into ميم. Then we make something called غنة. غنة means to stop on the letter for a while. And when you are stopping some voice coming from your nose, like this one, فهو على نور من. Look, نور من. When you stop, there is some no, some voice coming or some sound coming from your nose. So we called it إدغام بغنة. من ربه. Also here the نون, as you see, it has no حركة. It means this نون having نون سكون. Then after نون there is راء. Here we make إدغام but without غنة. إدغام بلا غنة. إدغام بلا غنة. إدغام without غنة. So we say من ربه. As we said, إدغام means if you have نون سكون or تنوين, you will change into the next letter. Here the next letter is راء, so this نون will be راء. من ربه. الله أكبر, الله أكبر, الله أكبر. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. لا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. 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 الله أكبر الله أكبر. لا إله إلا الله وأنا أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. اللهم رب هذه الدعوة التامة والصلاة القائمة آت محمدا الوسيلة والفضيلة وابعث اللهم مقاما محمودا الذي وعدته. رضيت بالله ربا وبالإسلام دينا وبمحمد صلى الله عليه وسلم نبيا ورسولا. اللهم صل على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما صليت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. اللهم بارك على محمد وعلى آل محمد كما باركت على إبراهيم وعلى آل إبراهيم إنك حميد مجيد. Now inshallah we continue. So مِن رَبِّهِ or مِن رَبِّهِ إِضْغَام but without غُنَّةِ. فَوَيْلٌ لِلْقَاسِيَةِ. Also here we have تنوين بالضمة two ضمة and then لام. Also we make إضغام without غُنَّةِ. So the تنوين فَوَيْلٌ this تنوين will change into لام. So we'll say فَوَيْلٌ فويل للقاسية من ذكر الله من ذكر إخفاء حقيقي same as أفمن شرح at the beginning. I also forgot قلوبهم من ميم سكون this also ميم having no حركة so you can see the ميم have no حركة no فتحة no كسرة no ضمة so this also means the ميم here having سكون so ميم سكون and then another ميم so we make إضغام it will be like one ميم with غنة we say إضغام مثلين إضغام مثلين أولئك مد واجب متصل مد واجب متصل and before مد there is on واو you can see on واو there is something looks like the ordinary سكون like something round in the ordinary Arabic language we make the سكون like this one but in Quran this doesn't mean سكون This one means صفر مستدير صفر مستدير صفر مستدير means this letter will not be pronounced so this wow will not be pronounced this is the meaning of صفر مستدير في ضلال مبين إضغام تنوين إضغام بغنة إضغام بغنة so I think ما شاء الله until now it's very easy إن شاء الله to follow الله نزل أحسن الحديث كتابا متشابها كتابا also تنوين then ميم ومك إضغام with غنة كتابا كتابا متشابها also متشابها مثاني also إضغام بغنة same تق قلقلة yes بارك الله فيكم قلقلة تقشعر منه منه we have نون سكون نون سكون and then هاء here we make إظهار حلقي please remember the words if some brothers or sisters are following us online, you can write down إظهار حلقي. إظهار حلقي means I will pronounce the noon clearly. So here we say منه. We don't do إخفاء, same as we did أفمن شرحة. Also, we will not make غنة. Will not make idgham like fawailul lilqasiyah for example or nurim min. This one idhar halq means the noon will be pronounced very clearly. Juludul ladina yakhshawna rabbahum thumma talinu. Thumma, this also another rule of tajweed. When we have mim or noon with shadda, we make ghunna. To stop on the letter for while. So here we say thumma, thumma. تلين جلودهم وقلوبهم إلى ذكر الله. ذكر الله. The word Allah. ترقيق or تفخيم. ترقيق. Because as we said before, there is كسرة. ذكري كسرة. So here like Bismillah, same. We make tarqiq. So dhikrillah, we don't say dhikr Allah. Thalika hudallah. Here opposite the word Allah, tafkhim. Yahdi bihi may, idgham bi ghunna, may yasha. Here we have mad. We make the alif longer for four harakat. So we say مد واجب متصل. مد واجب متصل. We make it four harakat. من يشاء ومن يضلل إضغام بغنة. يضلل الله لفظ الجلالة ترقيق بارك الله فيك ترقيق. يضلل الله فما له we say this one مد صلة من هاد إخفاء إظهار سوري إظهار حلقي نون ها إظهار حلقي also for دال قلقلة because we stop with سكون من هاد أفمن يتقي إضغام بغنة بوجه قلقلة جيم بوجهه سوء مد واجب متصل okay before that مد صلة as you said yes then سوء مد واجب متصل فور حركات وقيل للظالمين ذوقوا ما كنتم نون سكون and then تاء إخفاء حقيقي ما كنتم تكسبوا كذب الذين من قبلهم نون also قاف إخفاء حقيقي من قبل قلقل إنباء قبلهم فأتاهم العذاب من حيث من من نون and then ح إظهار حلقي من حيث لا يشعرون فأذاقهم الله لفظ الجلالة الله تفخيم فأذاقهم الله تفخيم الخزي في الحياة الدنيا الدنيا as we said before do you remember إظهار مطلق yes بارك الله فيك إظهار مطلق so the noon here will be clearly pronounced الدنيا ولعذاب الآخرة أكبر لو كانوا يعلمون ولقد قلقلة ضرب قلقلة أرسباء ضربنا للناس غنى النون في هذا القرآن من كل إخفاء حقيقي مثل لعلهم إدغام بلا غنة. يس. مثل لعلهم يتذكرون. قرآنا عربيا إظهار حلقي تنوين أنذن عين. عربيا غ أرتو إظهار حلقي. So now for إظهار حلقي, how to know there is إظهار حلقي? Very easy. After noon سكون or تنوين, you will find one of six letters. Remember those six letters. همزة, همزة, هاء, كي, حاء, خاء, عين, غين. So if you see any of these letters coming after noon sukun or tanween, you have to pronounce the noon or tanween very clearly. We say إظهار حلقي. Again, the six letters: همزة, هاء, حاء, خاء, عين, غين. Now in this ayah, سبحان الله, we find the عين and غين. قرآنا ع, عين. عربيا غ, غين. Okay. Before we had also هاء, منه, هاء. من كل إخفاء حقيقي. يس. كل مثل لعلهم, القرآن عربيا, غير ذي عوج لعلهم, عوج لعلهم, إدغام without غنة, بلا غنة. ضرب الله also تفخيم for the word الله. ضرب الله مثلا رجلا, إدغام بلا غنة, فيه شركاء مد واجب متصل ومكت فور حركات, متشاكسون, ورجلا سلما إخفاء حقيقي, سلما لرجل, إدغام بلا غنة, إدغام without غنة. هل يستويان مثلا؟ الحمد لله, بل أكثرهم لا يعلمون. إنك غنة, ميت وإضغام بغنة, وإنهم غنة, وإنهم ميتون, إضغام مثلين, ميم 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 سكون عند أنظر ميم ميم فتحة. ثم إنكم غنة, إن ميم أنت نون, يوم القيامة عند إخفاء حقيقي ربكم تختصمون. So الحمد لله, we finished the تجويد of the آيات. For brothers or sisters who are following us online, if you are beginners, you don't need to understand 100% the rules of تجويد, but you can get this time some rules, and of course every week inshallah we are repeating the rules, so time by time inshallah you can improve your tajweed and learning the all rules inshallah of tajweed. Now the time for your questions inshallah. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask. Fadal. وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.
My question is about the how can we respond to the ayah mukammat and ayah mustahabihat. For example, if like there is ayah mustahabihat, does this mean that the, for example, if like some hukum is taken from this ayah, the scholar all agree, and then mustahabihat, that means that the scholars have different opinions.
Yes, for ayat muhkamat means the meaning is very clear. Like for example, when we say هو الله, he is Allah. This one muhkama, this ayah muhkam means no one believer will have different opinion. all will agree there is only one God, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But some ayat mutashabihat, the meaning is not so clear. So in this case, to be safe, try to understand it according to the way or guidance of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Like for example, in one ayah of Al-Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, يَدُ اللَّهِ فَوْقَ أَيْدِيهِمْ, the hand of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala on their hands. So here, this ayah, you cannot say it in physically, because it will lead to something not accepted. So at that time, better to understand it according to the guidance of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Sahaba, for example, they never ask about the meaning of this. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam never talk about the meaning of this. All of them, they don't talk. But later, some of the Muslim people or scholars, they start to talk and start to have different opinions regarding to this, and this actually big problem. So better to be safe for a Muslim to understand what the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam understood, he and his Sahaba. Don't go for any argue. Any other question, inshallah? Yes.
About the Al-Quran is the best of speech or the best of kitab.
Mm-hmm.
How about the other kitab, for example, like Injil or Torah? How should we respond to that? I mean, we just believe that there are these kitab, or do we also need to maybe know some the content of it for some extent? Or?
Of course, we believe in all holy books of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, revealed to the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as mentioned, for example, Suhuf Ibrahim. When we recite Surah Al-A'la, Surah Al-A'la, Sabbih Isma Rabbika Al-A'la, we'll find the last ayah, Suhuf Ibrahim wa Musa. Suhuf Ibrahim wa Musa. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed sheets to Ibrahim alayhi salam, revealed also Tawrat to Musa alayhi salam, revealed the Injil to Isa alayhi salam, revealed the Zabur to Dawood alayhi salam. So there are many holy books Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And one part of our iman, one part of our belief in Islam, that to believe in all the holy books of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala revealed to the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. At the same time, also we believe that Al-Quran al-Kareem not changed, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala promised that He will protect Al-Quran from any change from people. That's why the Holy Quran from the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam until now, until the Day of Judgment, not change. Nobody can change even one letter in Al-Quran, because Allah protected it. And if someone change, it will be very clearly appear. Very clearly it will be appear. Okay? But for the other holy books of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the people changed the books from the original revelation, they change it. But for us, we believe that Allah revealed the holy books. But only Al-Quran al-Kareem, Allah promised to protect it, not the others. Yes, inshallah.
beauty and nur. Here is the meaning mentioned. Iman.
Yes, nur here means guidance, hidayah, guidance Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala giving to the heart of the believer, as we said, to see things very clearly, to know his way to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala clearly, to see things around him in the proper way, to see it clearly right or wrong, not to have any confusion. I think also for the brothers and sisters who are following us, if they have questions, they can also say.
No question.
Okay. If they have questions, they can write, inshallah. Okay. Inshallah. Any other question, inshallah, from brothers here? Okay, inshallah, if not, so alhamdulillah, we finish in this point, and inshallah, we will continue reciting Surah Az-Zumar next week, inshallah, from ayah 32 until ayah 40, the next page, inshallah, Rabbil Alameen. Subhanak Allahumma wa bihamdik, nashhadu an la ilaha illa ant, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk, assalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Exactly.